I'm going to start off by saying that this is one of the most unfair comparisons we've ever done. So when I first set this up, I thought, okay, here are two subcompact crossovers that are kind of outlier choices, and they take two totally different approaches. So this is going to be awesome. And then I drove the Mini for like 2 seconds. I remembered why I liked it so much. And we're basically setting up the poor Encore for a devastating loss. But then once you look into it, you'll realize that the Encore last year outsold the Countryman by 6 times. So what the hell? Maybe the Encore actually has a fair chance? Personally, I have a really hard time accepting the fact that the Encore outsells Mini by that much. We're talking 78,500 Encores versus 12,700 Countrymans. But they do have a few similarities. The obvious choices and top 3 sellers in this segment are the Jeep Renegade, the Subaru Crosstrek, and the Honda HR-V. But these two both skew a little bit more to the luxury side of the segment and start in the mid-20s and easily climb into the 30s when well equipped. But that's about where the similarities end. These two crossovers could not be more different. Starting with style, the Encore is one of the most dorky looking subcompact crossovers in the segment. It looks squished and the proportions are all wrong, and it just looks like a little piggy on stilts. But there is an upside to those awkward proportions, and that is excellent headroom. The Mini, on the other hand, looks fantastic. It's fun and it's cute, and it takes everything that we like from smaller Minis and applies it to a bigger crossover, and none of the cuteness or personality is lost in the process. The Mini can also pass as looking sporty and a bit rugged, but the Encore just looks odd. The Mini's interior is also much, much more interesting than what Buick has to offer. Like, I love these quilted leather seats, the circular dashboard display, and these little retro toggle switches that are just delightful. In general, automakers' interiors are usually really boring, and so I really commend Mini for putting in the extra effort to make it this interesting. Well, I think all of that personality is really cool. Some people might find it a bit confusing. Some of the controls are not entirely obvious, and things are located in strange places. I'm also not a fan of this infotainment system either. The menu structure isn't that intuitive, and although it looks pretty cool, it's not that easy to use. It's based on BMW's iDrive system, so you can use the touchscreen or control it with this little knob. You can also draw letters on top of the knob to input addresses and stuff, so you don't have to waste time scrolling through the letters. I don't love either option, just give me a keyboard on the touchscreen. And while I love the Mini's unique and fun interior, the one in the Buick is a lot more familiar and easier to get used to. Everything is laid out smartly, and it's a little bit boring, but there's nothing inherently wrong with it. It just works, and it's comfortable too. I don't love this interior, but I do prefer Buick's infotainment system over Mini's. It's just more straightforward and user-friendly. The fact that it comes with a 4G LTE Wi-Fi hotspot is a huge bonus. And it also has a nice matte finish screen that seems pretty resistant to fingerprints. The Buick isn't even that much more practical than the Mini, making me even more confused as to why so many people buy it. The Mini is rated to have more rear seat legroom, and the Encore beats the Countryman for cargo capacity, but just by a little bit. The Encore has 18.8 cubic feet in the trunk and 48.4 with the rear seats folded flat, while the Mini has 17.7 in the trunk and 47.6 with the seats folded, so it's not a big enough difference to be a huge deal. I also found it really difficult to find a comfortable driving position in both cars. I was actually really surprised by how this bigger Countryman drives. I thought it would be too big and heavy to be fun, but it actually drives a lot like a traditional Mini, meaning it makes you want to just juke around in the city and have some fun with it. You know, it's got a really great, playful personality, and a lot of it comes down to this fantastic steering setup. It's just got a nice weight to it, it's very responsive, and I feel like that's a very rare characteristic in the subcompact crossover segment. The Mini we're driving is the sportier Countryman S model, so it does have a totally unfair advantage over the Buick. Base Countrymans, though, come with a 1.5-liter 3-cylinder engine with 134 horsepower and 162 pound-feet of torque, but this S model gets the upgraded 2-liter 4-cylinder that has 189 horsepower and 207 pound-feet. It's enough to make the Mini feel really alive. Our S model has an 8-speed automatic, which isn't perfect because it has hard shifts from time to time, but you can even get it with a 6-speed manual, which is really nice. Base Countrymans get a 6-speed auto. Driving the Countryman, it just reminded me of why I enjoy minis so much. They're just so much fun and it doesn't take itself too seriously. The car puts me in a good mood with its balanced handling, fantastic suspension, which is stiff enough to feel sporty, but not so stiff that your fillings fall out. Meanwhile, the Buick's drive compared to the Mini is just so boring. Like, it just takes itself way too seriously, and fun isn't something that this Buick does. Not that it needs to, and I know that it's at a huge disadvantage compared to the Mini, especially because it's an S model, but even compared to the base model, which is a three-cylinder, it's still pretty meh. It does what it needs to do without any excitement, and there's nothing wrong with that either. The Buick is powered by a turbocharged 1.4-liter four-cylinder engine with 153 horsepower and 177 pound-feet of torque, and the little CUV actually gets going pretty decently. There isn't much to comment on how the Encore drives, it's just completely average. It's definitely a more comfortable setup with a softer suspension, and I think a lot of people might like that. So why the hell does the Encore outsell the Mini 6-to-1? It probably comes down to a few things. Buick has a better dealer network, Mini doesn't have the best reputation when it comes to reliability, and pricing is probably a huge factor too. The Buick is much more affordable than the Mini, even though the Mini has more tech available. The base Countryman starts at about $27,000, while the Encore starts at about $23,000. As tested, our top trim Encore rings in at about $35,000, while our fully loaded Countryman S stickers at a much more hefty $41,000. I think a lot of people might be scared off by Mini because it's so different and a lot more expensive. So to wrap it up, I love the Mini's fun and balanced driving dynamics, funky look, and really cool interior, but is a lot more expensive and has a sometimes confusing infotainment system. The Buick counters that with a better infotainment system, a nice comfortable ride, and a much more affordable price, but it is more boring in almost every other aspect. I can tell you that for me, the Mini wins this comparison hands down. It's just so great to drive and has such a fun personality. I would also get rid of the more expensive options just to make it a bit more affordable. But the fact that the Buick outsells the Mini by such a huge margin really tells you what the market wants, and that's something familiar to drive with no surprises. Driving dynamics are really important for me, but not everyone feels that way. So if you want a driver's car, definitely pick the Mini. If you want to play it safe, then the Encore is a better choice. So if you have a pulse, you'll probably like the Mini. If you're over 60 and really tired all the time, then be... I can't even...
That was actually great.